Look who's back. It is I. Hey guys, it's Sarah, and today, yes, we are doing an update vlog. I haven't done one of these in probably a month. But anyway, I have a feeling this video could be long, so let's just get right into it. So here's the latest news that's been happening in the past month. Oh my god, there is something in my eye. The first thing I want to talk about in this video is the article that came out recently, maybe a couple weeks ago. And within this article, Louis was talking to Metro about Christmas time and spending time with his family. So basically in this first paragraph right here, Louis is just talking about how Christmas is a really fun time for his family. He likes watching his siblings open the presents. Whenever he mentions Santa, everybody gets really happy. You know, just like common happy stuff. And as we go more throughout the article, Louis talks more about songwriting and releasing his music, which I really was excited about reading. This is what I want to read. So Louis says, "It has been a very experimental time for me musically because my musical interest isn't where radio is at the moment." Which I didn't know how to feel about that sentence. Like, does Louis think his music isn't good enough for radio, or is it just a fact that his music wouldn't be contemporary enough to be on the main pop radio stations? Because I know, biased opinion, but Louis's music should be on the radio stations. I think they're good enough. But Louis has stated on his Twitter recently that he will be releasing music this year. So that is confirmed. We don't know if it's a full album of like 10 to 15 songs. We don't know if it's like a 5-song type of thing or a couple songs. I don't care. Even if Louis just came out with one song, I would be happy. I just want to see some music from Louis. That's it. And I want to see just all the boys tweet some more, maybe come back in a band. That'd be nice. But it's like any day now. Come on. But going back to Louis' music, he says, "I've written over 100 songs. I'm going to be so freaking relieved when I actually sign off on it and take a breather from writing. I'm almost out of concepts. It has been a very experimental time for me musically because my musical interest isn't where radio is at the moment. A lot of radio is R&B and hip-hop. Growing up in the North, loving bands like Arctic Monkeys and Oasis, that's not the type of music I want to make. I want to be the middleman." So, as I was saying before, I don't really know how to feel about this. I think that Louis should feel like whatever music he makes, it is worthy of going on the radio, or it deserves to be played. I think nowadays, contemporary radio stations, like Louis says, plays just a lot of pop and hip-hop R&B. But I kind of wish more of the pop contemporary radio stations would give other genres a chance. Why can't pop artists kind of go maybe out of that realm and make like a mix of genres? Like Louis said, like Arctic Monkeys or Oasis. I love those bands. I would love to hear more modern artists make like a blend. And to be honest, artists have done this in the past. Look at Bruno Mars and like other artists. They have mixed a lot of genres together and made it into something modern. And it's been accepted on radios because of the artists they are. So I think if Louis really makes more of a name for himself and the fans really make it happen for him, his songs can go on the radio. Because I think it's not only the music you make, I think it's the artist you are too. Like for example, I think if Bruno Mars started making music like the Arctic Monkeys, I'm sure his songs would still end up on radio stations because it's Bruno Mars. I don't think people have to make pop to be relevant, but sadly, that's kind of how it seems nowadays. And that's just where the whole thing goes back to. Make music that you love, don't do it for the money and for the attention and fame, because then it's obvious, you become a sellout. There's been so many musicians who didn't like pop, but they had to resort to pop just to get money or to be relevant on radio stations. And Louis also talks to Metro about him winning the Celeb of the Year award. And we got a nice picture of Louis right here with his award. Honestly, deserves it. And regarding his Celebrity of the Year award, Louis basically saying that you shouldn't forget who you are. He didn't grow up with much, didn't have much luxury. So he is very appreciative of this special life that he has. And not that this was a surprise or anything, but I love how Louis says that he stayed grounded because of his mom and the way he was just brought up by his mom and his family. And a lot of people have said it. When they met Louis, he's a very humble and grounded person. He's not like other celebrities. Now moving on to some Larry news. Now the reason why I'm saying Larry news is because a lot of people have been thinking that Harry and Louis spent the holidays together. Not really confirmed. As usual, we don't get actual picture evidence of this. It's all speculation of what we usually see in the background or what we hear. So we got this video of Harry holding a child. I'm not the FBI, so I don't know who this child is. But this person says, according to Fizzy's comment, we can conclude that Louis was with Harry at the family's Christmas dinner in Cheshire last night and spent Christmas morning with him as well. Lottie showed everyone and he wasn't there and couldn't hear his voice in the background, and will go to see his family in Doncaster later today with his husband.
Smart with this.
Okay.
Sticky stuff.
Yeah, there you go. Sticky stuff.
Sticky stuff.
Top hands. Top hands. Honey.
So, okay, to me, the speculation isn't totally ridiculous. Like, it's not off the charts. I don't think it's really tin-hatting. I can see why people would think, like, oh, Louis might be with Harry because he wasn't with them. But again, we don't have this physical picture evidence. If you want like my logical opinion, I will have to say that, come on, if Harry and Louis are at least friends, there's no reason why they wouldn't hang out. I mean, look, Louis's birthday is a day before Christmas. Don't you think Harry would have probably hung out with Louis at least once over the holidays? So I don't think it's ridiculous for Larry's to think that Louis and Harry were hanging out. I feel like I'm just repeating myself at this moment, so. It doesn't just stop there with the Larry proof. We got another updated picture of Harry walking around Tokyo with a palace bag. I think that's how you pronounce it. And you might be thinking, how does this even connect to Larry or Louis? Well, our fandom, aka the FBI, found out that Louis recently followed the palace brand on his Twitter. So people are making it sound like Louis followed this brand first, and then we see Harry walking around with the bag. Timelines really confuse me in this fandom because I'm always hearing about things late. I don't know when things actually happen. But a lot of people are saying that this palace company is like a sports company, and people are saying, why would Harry be walking around with that type of merchandise if he's not really into that? But Louis is. So they're thinking that Harry didn't just buy this randomly. He probably got it because, you know, Louis follows them. He's into that kind of thing. So maybe Louis got it for Harry, or maybe Louis got Harry into that sort of thing. Again, I know I sound crazy. Maybe that sounds like a reach. Half of you might be thinking that this theory is correct, and half of you might be thinking, why can't Harry just buy a bag and why do we have to analyze it? I'm kind of torn between the two because I kind of agree with both. For some reason in this fandom, things just always kind of match up. But look, even if some of you watching think that this theory is ridiculous, you have to give our fandom credit. We are really good at looking into things. And nope, it doesn't just stop there. We have yet another Larry proof. So basically, we recently got this picture of Louis with a Tokyo Squad shirt, and then someone made this analysis connection. So they said, Louis really did that. Tokyo Squad, guess who's in Tokyo? Harry. 1994, which is Harry's birth year. 18, well, we all know what that means. Pride makes me think of, they want to buy my pride, but that just ain't up for sale. I think it's safe to say Louis is being really loud. And it says, this is the back of the shirt Louis was wearing in the club, neighborhood Tokyo Squad, craft with pride. And it says, the meaning of the word iconic stems from Louis managing to cram both Tokyo and pride onto one shirt while Harry is in Japan. Okay, so I do understand how the fans are making this connection, but I think sometimes we kind of reach a little bit. I think our fandom just has to understand that just because a couple things connect with Louis and Harry, I don't think that really leads anywhere. Like, what does this prove? Like, yeah, we have speculated these things and they kind of connect, like there's some similarities, but what does this mean? Does this mean that Louis and Harry are together? Does this mean that they're hanging out? Does this mean that they like the same things? Like, what are we concluding here aside from, oh, these two things are similar? And that's what I try to find out in the Larry fandom. We can speculate all we want, we can draw conclusions, we can analyze and connect different things, but what are we getting at the end of the day? Like, I think some people are just reaching and they'll look at anything. Like, this is Tokyo and this is Tokyo and then this is Pride, and then they're relating it to things from like 3 years ago or a song lyric that Louis wrote from like a couple years ago. Not everything has to be connected. Not everything has to mean Larry. Why can't we just think that Louis and Harry are together because of old proof from the past, like actual legit stuff that we've seen with our eyes, and not stuff that, you know, doesn't really have hardcore evidence? In my opinion, if the analysis is very detailed and there's a lot of steps to understand why things are connected, then maybe it doesn't mean anything. I think the things that are very clear and unbiased people can see it too, that means something. I think this analysis right here is only reeling in people who are in the fandom. So of course we're going to think that it's true and that it means something because we're biased. We're a part of the fandom. But if you can get people outside of the fandom to believe this same thing, then that means something. This is the end of the video. This is all I wanted to talk about for today. I understand there's probably some more Babygate analysis I didn't touch upon. Basically, Babygate is ending. Tammy and Brianna are just embarrassing themselves on Instagram. I mean, there's more to do with it, like accounts and stuff. I might get into that with another video, but I'm just not gonna get into it in this video. Maybe I'll share some of the Babygate analysis on my Twitter. So again, if I missed anything, just leave it down below. And like always, I make a new video whenever I want, so like and subscribe. All my social media is down in the description, and I will see you guys later. Bye.